20 years later, it hasn't lost even one little bit of its magic. The string suites still give us goosebumps. Poignant melodic moments still make us pause and think about our lives and the relationships in them. The successes and the failures, the doubts and the tender moments, and the write-offs and the goodbyes. We've all loved someone who was, to us, the magic that holds the sky up from the ground. We've all had to say goodbye to someone we loved. We've all known a Jane who pretends to be someone she's not because she thinks she's not enough. Reinhold Messner is in every way just as relatable and relevant as it was the day it was released. But I asked the Cashews, why this album in particular? Albums have significant anniversaries all the time, and there are certainly other great albums you could have done. For example, Abbey Road celebrates 50 years this September. So why is this album special? The brothers replied, oh crap, we should have done Abbey Road. No, they didn't say that. Devin said, I served my mission from 02 to 04, and one of the hardest things for me was being without the music I loved for those years. When you're without music for that amount of time, you begin to realize which music you missed the most. Reinhold Messner was the first album I listened to when I got home. It was a long day full of reuniting with family and friends. When everyone had gone home or gone to bed, I sat on the couch in my parents' family room by myself, put on the album and just cried. I love this album. Brady said, it was like something I had never experienced before. I always loved music, but I never loved albums. Ben Folds 5 Music had spoken to me like no other rock band had up to that point. I knew Ben Folds was talented, but I didn't realize to what extent until I heard Reinhold Messner. I quite literally couldn't stop listening to the album once I discovered it. I know it inside and out. I think the first six tracks are maybe the best sequence of music I've heard on record. I also have spent a lot of time crying while listening to this album, both happy and sad tears. Bucky said, for me, the Reinhold Messner album represents the first time Brady and I connected in a meaningful way. Growing up, we were as different as siblings could be, each a black sheep in his own way. It wasn't until we were both adults that our true friendship began. Music was always a very important part of each of our lives, but I can clearly remember sitting in the car with Brady, listening to this album, and putting years of silence behind us. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, you are here either because you love the album or you love the Cashews, or perhaps both are true. After tonight, you will certainly leave with a heightened appreciation for both. So without further ado, here is the unauthorized biography of Reinhold Messner by Cash Folds 5!
Thanks for being here, guys. And the story is that Darren Jesse, who was the drummer of Ben Folds 5, was making fake IDs with his friends. And they found some source that they could get their picture put on a fake ID card. But the name on it was always Reinhold Messner. So there were a bunch of underage kids walking around in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, getting booze, and they were all named Reinhold Messner. they found out later on, and this was even after the album had been printed, that Reinhold Messner is a real man. He was actually the first person to ever climb Mount Everest without any oxygen. So he's a world famous climber. And I think later on he heard the album and sent them an email and told them that he thought it was special and he really liked it. So the next song on the album is called Don't Change Your Plans. And when it was first brought to the studio, Ben Folds originally had a 12-minute song. And the record producer said, "No, that's not going to work." And he chopped it up and turned it into just a standard pop song. But it's a really, really good song. It's my personal favorite on the album, and so we're going to do it now. Thanks.
Thank you.
I'm going to talk about this next song. This song is probably my favorite song on the album. It's tough to choose, but this song is called Mess, and Ben Folds talked about it as being a song about the loss of innocence in your life, and as you get older and older, you kind of start to look back on your life and realize what a mess you've made of it over the years. And it's a very kind of melancholy, full of despair song. There's a line in it where the lyric, he says, "There are rooms in this house that I don't open anymore, dusty books and pictures on the floor, and she'll never see that part of me." And it's so true. I think that we all can look back in our lives and there are these parts of ourselves and these memories that we've had, these choices that we've made that we really don't want anybody to know about, and there are these rooms in our house that we don't want to go into anymore. So this is Mess. supposed to say some things. Mostly I'm just glad y'all are here. This is a great album and we hope to do it justice, but yeah, mostly we're just thankful for all the support and thankful to the players, everyone who volunteered their time, including our sound guy, Ryan Davis. Thanks so much. This song is called Magic, and yeah, I like it quite a lot. I think when I was younger, it's kind of funny, now I am going to say something. When I was younger, I you know, was always heartbroken and a hopeless romantic, and so I always thought that this song was about, you know, being in love, and the person you love is magic, and love is magic, and, you know, the older I've gotten, the more I think that it might, especially because some of the lyrics might be about someone you love who's getting older, and, you know, somebody who... is important to you.
Smiled in my room. Shut the love.
Houston. Next song is called Hospital Room. We're gonna roll right into Army after it.
Lying awake in my hospital room,
Is where the album gets really artistic. We're gonna invite my dad up, Nick Cash.
Grandpa!
So this song.
The reason
what?
We're all here.
It's his fault.
I know, man.
Ben Folds got a message from his dad at around 6 in the morning, and he was not quite awake, and he wasn't making a lot of sense. And so they took this recording of his dad, and they put it to music. So Nick's gonna read the recording, and we're gonna put it to music. Keep
this. 6:49 a.m. Friday, November 20th.
Good morning, Mr. Ben. About 6:30, Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Just laying here in the bed, half awake, half asleep, thinking about you. I was wondering if you were looking after your most valuable possession, your mind. I was thinking about John Glenn, his space journey and all. They said that when you're in space, you lose muscle mass and the body mass. And I wondered if there was any end to it. Oh, whether if you didn't exercise in space, how long it would be before you were just a head or mind or have no body or arms. Well, you'd have them. You couldn't use them. I was wondering if your body mass would drop to a certain level and then it would stop right there and keep whatever you needed to use, your mind, because it would still be working. Oh, 30 seconds remaining. Anyway, I was just pondering that, but what do you think about that? I hope everything is going all right. I may wake up here in a little while and forget what I was thinking about.
Grandpa!
This song is called Regrets. I thought about sitting on the floor in second grade. I couldn't keep the pace. I thought I was the only one moving in slow motion. screw up, I have to turn the mic. Very well until we played it. And now he likes it a little bit more, I think.
Who's playing the bells and ticketing drums?
this song is called Lullaby, and apparently it originally got inspired because one of Ben Folds' ex-wives ended up on a plane alone with James Earl Jones. And it turned into maybe the loveliest song on the album, so.
Right, before we start, we have to thank Ratio Audio, Ryan and Jason. They have been here since 9:30 this morning, probably. It's unbelievable the amount of time and work that they were willing to just donate. I mean, it wasn't even really a question, you know? And there were things that we wanted to do for this project that I don't know how much it would have cost us to rent this equipment and all the microphones and find a guy that could actually do it. I think he said that 31 out of his 32 inputs on his soundboard are used right now. out of 32. I think that we just, maybe one was just for good measure, so we could say we did it. Or maybe it was the bells. But thanks a bunch, you guys. It's been a real honor and a great time.
Can we go home?
I'm going to save some embarrassment. We did not prepare an encore. Just in the off chance, you know. We could fall off the stage this song. And it could end in total catastrophe, but there would not be an encore regardless of how this song goes.
Aww.
That's what Mom said.
Is this
I'm thinking
that's
karaoke is the encore.
Is this the very last song?
Good night, good night, sweet babe. The world has more for you than it seems. Good night, good night. Let the moonlight take the lid off your dreams. good night, sweet babe.
Space for tonight. Will you please, 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 please make it really clean before you leave? Walk down the aisle. If you see the littlest smidgen of a crumb of something, just if you'd please pick it up, that would mean a lot to me and us. So thank you. Thanks for coming, everybody. Thank you.